All right, so be sure and find your mute button. And all right, let's talk all things Facebook parties. All right, so hi guys, my name is Michelle Withers. I'm the owner of Creative Success Systems, and I'm super excited to talk to you about virtual parties. This is a really fun subject. So many of you I can see, so give me a wave and let me know how many of you, give me a wave if you are working towards having more virtual parties than home parties. Who's a virtual partier? Okay. How many of you still have some home parties? A couple of you do. Okay, awesome. Fantastic. That's fabulous. All right. So this is I think you're going to be really excited to hear how we do parties. Just out of curiosity, how many of you joined me last week on our webinar that had to do with booking parties and hostess coaching? Anybody join me on that one? Just a couple of you. Oh, wow. Okay. You were there. It was great, wasn't it? It was a really fun webinar. All right. So let's get started and let's talk about all things Facebook parties. So one of the things that I teach people, it's really important to understand, is a thing called an initial touch. How many of you have heard my teachings about initial touches? Who knows what that is? Oh, just a couple of you. Okay. There is a couple. All right. So an initial touch, let me tell you the power in this. I really have a pretty strong opinion about not cold messaging people, that we need to care more about people than we care about how much about sales, that always needs to be our first priority, is caring about people, okay? And I'm sure you get that. You're like, well, of course, we should care more about humans than we care about getting the sale. But it's the way that we do it is the way, depending on how we do it, will help people see that part of us, okay? Can you agree that sometimes people have good intentions, but sometimes those intentions don't come through very well? Have any of you seen that happen? Okay? And so, and plus I kind of feel like as we started as direct sellers saying a phrase, things like sharing is caring, that sometimes that sharing is caring has got a little misunderstood exactly what that means. I joke all the time, Cookie Monster didn't shove cookies down people's throats. He only shared them if they wanted them, okay? And so we kind of need to know first if they want things before we share it. So I do this thing called an initial touch, and the whole goal of it is when we send messages to people, the reason why I'm telling you this is how I like you to start your parties, but you need to understand the basis behind it so that it's easier to come up with good questions to ask. So the first thing that we want to do is understand this thing called initial touch. And the great thing about an initial touch is it's also a great way to reach out to people and book parties. Okay. So let me just ask you real quick. As a general rule, how many of you kind of use a message like this, whether it's via text or it is via Facebook Messenger, when you're trying to book parties, and it's someone who has said they'd have a party one day, okay? Or even someone who may need to order additional product, and you're like, well, you might as well get the product for free and book a party. So you send a message out, hey, Susie, you talked about having a party in March. I'm getting my March calendar filled. I do parties on Tuesdays or Thursdays. Which of those would work best for you? How many of you have been taught to send some sort of message similar to that? Okay. Are any of you like send something like really, really different than that? Is that kind of a general? You do a little, a few of you do. Okay, great. So this is my take on how to reach out and get conversations started with messaging with regards to booking parties, okay? When we use what's called an initial touch, this is gonna show how much you care, okay? So the first thing we wanna do is we wanna make sure that we're focused on them, and sometimes you know what's going on in their life, okay? When they said, oh, I'll have a party in March, and let's say they were at a party in November, a lot of times you know if they were moving, if they were having a baby, if they were having surgery. A lot of times you know that there is something going on Okay, that wasn't the norm. And if you can remember what the circumstances in their life was. So Heather, darling, you just shared screen. That happens to a lot of people. They just hit the wrong button. Could you unshare for me, sweetheart? Okay, no big deal. It happens to lots of us. So Heather, if you can unshare, that would be awesome. Can you do that for me? Heather Slocum, forgive me if I'm saying that way wrong. Heather, can you hear me? See me? Any of the above? Can you stop screen sharing? Let's see if we can find her here. There you go. Thanks, darling. All right. So what we want to do is send out a message to people via text or via Facebook Messenger. And we say, hey, Susie, if I remember back in November when we chatted, you were going to be having a new baby soon. How's it going being a mom? Okay. We want to ask them, you know, how are things going since your mom passed? How are things going? Whatever the circumstances were, if you can remember, that will score you very big points. That will show them how much you care about them as people, okay? And the thing with an initial touch is when you message about product, about booking, about ordering, about anything about the business, and they don't respond back to you, how many of you have the paranoid monkeys crawl up in your brain and go, they don't want to book a party, they're avoiding you, they're like every little negative thought like pop into your head. Anybody besides me like get all paranoid when people don't respond, okay? Now, let me tell you a little secret. In the day when we use this thing and it rang and we put it to our ear and we said hello, do you remember that day? Yeah, this thing actually does let you hear people's voices. But in the day where we actually talked on this thing, if we didn't answer, we just left a message and we didn't think much about the fact they didn't pick up. We assumed they would call back. And if people didn't pick up, we knew they were busy or they were, you know, if it was a home phone, you know, they weren't at home. We didn't let the paranoid monkeys get to us too bad. But when we message and they don't reply, for some reason, we're like, because we know they see 95% of their messages, right? And especially if the little word seen pops up on Facebook Messenger and they're like, they saw it, they didn't respond. They're avoiding me. I'm like, oh my gosh, guys, you can't use those kind of that kind of wording. How many of you have seen a message? You were driving, you were having a heated discussion with a spouse, you were dealing with a child, you were just headed to bed, you were shopping. I mean, we get messages no matter what we're doing. We're in the bathroom, okay? Like, messages come in that there's no like, hey, are you busy? You know what I mean? There's none of that. It just hits us no matter what we're doing. And we can't always instantly reply back. How many of you have meant to reply to a message and forgot? Text or messenger, okay? So this is the thing. I love free product. Your people love free product. I love to get together with friends. They love to get together with friends. But of all the things you have on your to-do list, now I know you as a consultant's a little bit different, but you as a hostess, is it on the top of your priority list? No way. Okay. We got bills, we got kids, we got jobs, we got, and yes, one night, every couple, you know, once a year, something, we have a party and it's on our list. But it is not up here. And you're expecting them to message you back. And, you know, at whatever moment you message and you have no idea where they're busy. And then you let the paranoid monkeys crawl up in your brain instead of going, people are busy. They may, like, have seen it. They may have totally forgotten to message me back. Okay? So what an initial touch does is, to me, it's that ring, ring, ring on the phone. Hey, do you have a quick minute to talk? And if they don't reply, that's where you get to stop and readjust your thinking and go, oh, okay, hang on. Okay, hang on a second. I don't have to take this personal. That's not what this meant. It did not mean they didn't want to talk to me necessarily. Now, there might be some that are avoiding having a party, but it's not as many as you think, okay? So when that initial touch, when they don't respond back, people love to talk about themselves. They really do. And let's say you're getting maybe two or three people to respond to a message like that. Hey, Susie, I know you want to have a party. You want to book it, blah, blah, blah. And you know you're not getting a very high percentage of responses to that. When you start sending initial touch, you're going to get more like seven plus out of 10 responses to those, because you showed that it was about them and people like to talk about themselves. Then they will talk about booking a party more likely. Now, will every one of them say yes, they'll book a party? No, but at least you know, instead of being paranoid. Paranoid's a yucky place to be, right? Would y'all agree with me? Am I the only one that feels that way? Okay, so this initial touch is super, super important, okay? And just as a quick story, there was a gentleman, and you'll have this happen to you a couple times. There was a gentleman that he was like 70 years old, and he'd been selling a health and wellness product for quite some time. And he was a bit of a powerhouse. Like, he just went for it. He wanted to help you, okay? But we all know those people with good intentions that sometimes don't always come off as caring as they could have as they're going for the sell, right? And he really did care about people's health. He just was a little edgy, okay? And so he had a lot of times he'd send out messages and people wouldn't reply. And it hurt his feelings and he was annoyed and he didn't care for that. Same thing, he had his own paranoid monkeys, right? And so I said, look, okay, do you have a list of people you want to follow up with? And he said, yeah, I do. And I said, okay, tell me a story of one of these people. Give me their background. So he said, well, there's this gal and she's a school teacher and she lives up in these hills where they've been having some forest fires. And it was in the summer. And I said, okay, so just message her and ask her how things are going, how the fires have affected her and her family. And he said, okay. So he sends him a message. He sends her a message and says, hey, Susie, I've been thinking about you. I know there were fires up in your area. How are you and your family? How did that impact your family? She says, oh my gosh, thank you so much for thinking of me. We were evacuated at one point, but we were really lucky. They were able to keep the fires from getting on our properties. So our animals are safe. Our house is safe. We're so grateful. And she says, oh my gosh, I'm going into the school season and I'm totally off my eating plan and I need some product and I'm so glad you messaged. Okay, now how many of you, is that not like the ultimate dream? You reach out and they tell you they need to order product, okay? So I'm going to tell you about 40 to 50% of the time when it's a past client, someone who said they'd book a party, someone who, like if you have a product that's consumable, you will be pleasantly surprised when you send out these initial touches, how often they'll bring up business on their own. Now they won't every time. Okay. I'll tell you that right now, but at least they respond to your text because I know how, or message, just know when I say text or face message, I'm talking about whether you're doing it via Facebook or texting, I don't care which one you're using, or maybe you're messaging via Instagram or Twitter, I don't care which one you're using. It's the same principle, okay? So it's really, really, really important to understand this, that initial touch is, it's a game changer, guys, okay? Now, if they don't bring up the party, you know, the fact that they had committed to a party on their own, the only thing you do, and this is a really, really important sentence, you won't remember it, okay? You'll be like, how did she say that? So please write it down word for word because I know y'all will be like, what? Okay, so all we do is ask, hey, do you have a quick minute that we could talk about the product that you ordered in the past? And I know there were some other things you're wanting. How interested are you hearing about some of the specials coming up? Like you just want to ask permission, okay? Ask them if they have time. Ask them if you can ask them about the product they ordered before. Okay? Always be very respectful and use that kind of language, and that will go a long ways. Okay? Hostess coaching, wording, those kind of things. I'm going to tell you about our Facebook camp weekend that we'll be having. And that weekend that we have, It is really, really awesome. And we do a lot more on hostess coaching. So just know we'll be telling you more about that here soon. Okay. But this is a really good start. So let me tell you how this plays into your parties. Okay. The first types of posts I like to post in a party. Now you have two different times you can do this. So everybody put in the comments how many days your parties are. Okay. That includes posts to like announce the party and get them like revved up for it. Like if you love a solid hour party, but you post for 2 days to get them excited about attending, then 2 days after you get orders, post how many days that you're posting. And then like, you know, if you like to have a one solid hour party, then go ahead and put that. Okay. So 90 minute parties, I think that time is really good. I don't know. See, I would love to watch somebody who does a 30 minute party. It kind of blows my brain how that works. But it's probably because I'm really wordy. I don't know. All right. Okay, cool. I love all this. 14 days of 30 minutes. Cool. Okay, lots of different ones. So I'm a big, big believer in you want to do some initial touch. You could do some initial touch when you first start engaging with people in the party. So like day one, some of your very first posts. And just say, hey, I want to know about you. And then I would probably have some, like, if you have like a block of time where you're doing a bunch of posts and videos, or you have a block of time and you're doing a Facebook Live, either way, I would do some what I call initial touch questions at the very beginning and in the beginning of what you consider your presentation. Y'all follow that? Is that you with me? Okay. You kind of have two beginnings depending on the way you structure your party. Not all of you do, but some of you do. Okay. So the first one I like to ask, because everybody loves to talk about their babies, is I would show a picture of my family, tell them a little bit about my family, say, I want to see a picture of your family. Tell me about yours. Do you have a sweetheart you love on? Do you have children at home? Do you have grandbabies? Do you have fur babies? Work really hard at using words that are very inclusive, okay? I like to say sweetheart. Some people have very committed relationships, aren't married. You have, you know, different types of marriages. You have people that, you know, have, you know, anyway, just make it as inclusive as possible so that everybody feels like they can answer that question. Or you could even add nieces and nephews, you know, those wonderful, amazing, you know, there's those people who love being aunts just as much as they love being moms sometimes, because being an aunt is their opportunity to have children in their life. Other times they're a great mom and a great aunt, okay? So just be as inclusive as you can so they can tell you about the people in their life that they love, okay? Does that make sense? All right? So that's my first question. And I think that would be a great one to do on day one, or maybe even like as people are starting to accept the invitations, starting to RSVP, those kind of things, maybe even on day two after you feel like you've maybe, you know, hit a maximum number of people who are going to participate, okay? But you want to show you care about them. Number two is I like to ask them what they love to do. If you had an hour of time that you could just do something relaxing that was for you and that would refresh you, what would you do in that hour of time? That and I talk about that I love to crochet and I love to do scarves because it's a very instant gratification kind of thing. I do pretty simple patterns that I just start and end. There's no attaching. I'm never going to do a sweater. Well, probably not anytime soon. Maybe when I'm retired or something, you know. I used to do afghans, but I'm not consistent enough and it like gets this wide and narrow. If you ever crocheted, you know what I mean? You get tighter, you get looser. If you stretch it out over a year, it doesn't usually look too uniform. I like instant gratification. I like my little scarves. So I tell them about my little scarf fetish, okay, and my crocheting. Tell them about something about you and then ask them what they would love to do. Okay. Just let them talk about them. Now, I want you to think about this for a minute. I'm going to talk to you about why we want to add people as friends on our Facebook parties. when you add them as friends and it's time to private message them, if you comment on how cute their fur babies are, if you comment on how you think it's amazing that they love Zumba and teach Zumba, if you comment on the fact that, you know, whatever it is that they do, that they love, that they told you about, you comment on that, that is going to show you care about them. Please listen to me. This is not a sales trick. This is a be deliberate, okay? I really love the book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. I mean, when you think about the things you do for your spouse or your significant other, things you do for your children, we deliberately stop and make time. We deliberately stop and make sure we give them compliments. We deliberately stop and make sure we, you know, do nice Valentine's things, nice gifts at Christmas. There's nothing wrong with being deliberate about making sure we mention something that was important to them. That is not manipulative. It is showing your true heart. Is everybody with me on this? Does this like make sense? Okay. You know, if somebody refers to, I think it's great that you make pies, what's your favorite kind of making, you get to talk about yourself, you know how important that makes you feel, right? It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter if they do the same thing. I'm trying to remember which book this was in. Someone was talking about that they had met this individual and they got talking about the thing, their occupation, and it was something like about bridges or dams or something. I mean, it was like this really like different, out, like not everybody could relate to topic. And the guy just sat and asked her questions about her career and how, what her involvement was in this. And at the end of the night, she told the host about the guy that she'd been sitting next to and what a great conversationalist he was and how interesting he was. And he just kind of laughed because he knew that what he did was listen. He didn't talk. He didn't share much about himself. He listened. And that woman just thought, he walked on water. It was an admiration, not a fall in love kind of thing. You see what I'm saying? But people love when you show that you've paid attention to something that's important to them. Okay. When I do my lives, when people are popping on, depending on how many people come on, when people come on and I've noticed it was their birthday, if I know they just had a baby, if I know that they've had a struggle, you know, someone passed away in their life, whatever it might be, you know, I try to give them a shout out. I try to say something. I can't always, and I don't remember everybody, especially like as our following is growing, it's getting harder. I need to still work on it. But as much as you can refer to people and what's important to them, it means a lot to them. Use their names, all those kind of things, okay? Those things all make a difference. So when you message them and you have this to refer back to, they are going to literally like you more. Anyone here besides me like to be liked? Okay. So it goes a long ways, okay? It's just common sense. That's all it is, okay? But because you're being taught these sales skills, a lot of times this stuff stepping back and really showing our heart isn't being taught as much as it used to and it needs to. We didn't change as human beings. We still like to be cared about, okay? Okay, so now what I'm going to teach you is I'm going to teach you the very simplified version of this. We go into this a lot more, like hours and hours of it during our weekend Facebook camp. But now that you've shown you've cared, now that you've asked some questions about them and their life, we want to start posting about product. So raise your hand and don't raise your hand until I say this. Okay. So I'm going to ask you what types of posts you do in your parties. Are you doing just images? Are you doing videos? Are you doing Facebook Live? So if you're doing posts in your parties, an image with some text, raise your hand. Who does some posts in your parties? Okay. Keep your hand raised if you're doing videos. You pre-record them and then you put the video out there. Okay. How many of you are doing Facebook Lives in your parties? How many are you doing lives in your parties? A lot of hands went down. Okay. That's good to know. All right. So here's what's important to understand. It does not matter what you're posting about with product. It doesn't matter what your videos are about. None of those things really matter. It doesn't matter which of those things you're using. Not that, sorry, that kind of sounded backwards. But what I mean is, whichever one you're choosing to use, if you start adding an open-ended question to every single one of those things, and it has to be open-ended, you will see a massive amount of engagement. You'll know what to private message them about, and you will see, literally, I'm not kidding, you can take a part, like if you're Pampered Chef, Norwex, there's some companies that really feel like a lot of times your parties will be higher in home than online. I'm telling you, I can help you get your parties up to the same amount they are in home as they are on, you can get them just as high online as you do in home if you do this correctly. Okay, so let me tell you a little bit about how this works. How many of you is just your first time hanging with me? Who knows? Oh, okay, let's do the opposite. So a couple of you, okay. Who knows I'm a question queen? Who knows? There's a chance. That was funny. Some of you don't. Okay, so question queen, the reason why I'm known as the question queen is because I'm a huge, huge, huge believer and people will talk to you on Facebook. It's called social media when you ask them to talk to you, okay? When you say, I want to know about you. I want to know if you like to cook. I want to know what your family likes to eat. I want to know if you like to wear makeup. I want to know what kind of earrings you wear. I want to know the ages of your kids. I want to know which room in the house you hate cleaning. I want to know about you. Instead of look how great the product is, look how great the product is. Most of what's being taught, okay, is here's what's great about my product, like it's a commercial, okay? You're not buying advertising time on TV. You're not buying paper space in a newspaper. You're not supposed to use those mediums mentally as a place to advertise, okay? Instead, this is still, when I started with direct sales 15 years ago, you know, we heard over and over again, this is a relationship type business. Your relationships is what makes this happen. Relationships, 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 okay? It all comes down to relationships. And if you don't believe that, like you're going to be blown away when you heard this statistic. Some of you might go, yeah, that's true. 90% of people don't have any idea what their coverage really is in their insurance. They bought it from the person they like the most. Okay? 90% of people don't totally know what their coverage is. There's a lot of each of you, whether your Usborne books or your Norwex or your Pampered Chef or your Unique or whatever you are, there's a whole bunch of you. You've got to stand out. You've got to show that you care about your circle of influence. Keep them as customers because they can buy a lot of other places. Besides them, there's the products that are similar but not as good at a store. Okay, you've got to take care of them. You've got to get them talking to you so you know exactly what to offer them. Okay, so let me run through some questions real quick. Those of you that have hung with me on this before, when you come up with ideas, help your girlfriends and your fellow gentlemen out here. Okay, whatever your company is, if you already have like had some question queen experience. But my first favorite type of question to put in your party is on a scale of 1 to 10. And these are easy, guys. Okay, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much you like to cook? On a scale of 1 to 10, how important is it to you to have jewelry on? On a scale of 1 to 10, how much do your children like to read? On a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you hate organizing paper? On a scale of 1 to 10, there's a million. Okay, so if you're one of my question queeners and you've been hanging out with me for a while, please go put in the comments, okay? Add some additional ideas in there of some of your favorite questions you've used that are on a scale of 1 to 10, okay? Because you know our time's short and I can't give them every company examples. You're going to help them, like, think outside the box, okay? My number two is how many days a week, okay? How many days a week do you wear makeup? How many days a week do your children read 20 minutes or more? How many days a week do you sweep the floor? How many days a week Okay, you can also change it to how many times a month, how many times a month you go on a date with your husband. You can also change it to how many times a day, how many times a day do you reapply your lipstick, all those kind of things. Now, if you notice here, they can answer these questions with one button, except for 10 is 10. It's a two-button response, but people still do it. The less buttons they have to push, the more likely they are to respond, okay? Now, my last one I'm going to share with you today, we have lots of them, but my last one I'm going to share with you today is multiple choice, okay? So you ask a question and you put different options, you type it out, you go to left align, you hit enter, so then you're left aligned, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we put in different options. Which of these is your family's favorite type of meat to eat? Which of these rooms of the house would you most love a cleaning genie for? Which of these types subjects in school are your children's favorite? And you put some options, okay? So if you have a multiple choice or days of the week question or frequency question that you've loved and you've used, put it in the chat. Help your friends out, okay? Because it takes practice, right? It really takes practice to do this. It pays off. It is totally worth it, but it does take some practice, okay? All right, so it cannot be a yes, no question. I'm not sure how, I haven't taught this too much. It's something I've been playing around with a lot. In my Facebook Lives, a lot of you will hear me say things like last week, it was really funny. We were talking about initial touches and how often we have sent out a message about having a party and someone has messaged us back and they're like, life has gone crazy. Like one gal messaged me and said, one of my clients, thank you so much for teaching me how to do initial touch because I sent this message to this gal and her house had just burnt down that week and I wanted to see if she wanted to have a jewelry party. That would have been really inappropriate to ask. So it was interesting because I asked everybody, how many of you have sent out a message? And it was like kind of tacky, you know, whatever. There's something that happened in their life and you felt like you'd kind of put your, you know, texting foot in your mouth. And I said, everybody comment with the word foot. If you feel like you put your foot in your mouth, reaching out to people, asking them to hold parties. So everybody had put the word foot. You should see. So if you're looking through the comments on the live, and you're like, what in the heck? Why was everybody commenting foot? Okay. But that is becoming a really effective way. You cannot ask yes, no questions. People seldom say yes or no. But if you say, if you relate to this, comment with this word, or do you lean more towards this or this, comment this word. If this is your thing, comment this word. If this is your thing. Those really, really help a lot to get some engagement. They probably work well. I've used them just in text. If those of you who are in my Facebook group saw, you know, I'm like, okay, guys, if you want to know about our upcoming webinar about parties, be sure and comment party below and we'll get the link. We have over 350 people who commented the word party on. Okay. But people do what you tell them to do. Like give them something specific to say and it really goes a long ways. Okay. But the yes, no stuff doesn't work. So this is my kind of like spin on yes, no is comment this word. Okie dokie. So when you add these, whatever you're doing now on your posts, on your videos, in your lives, when you start adding these questions to all of those things that you're doing, no matter how you're presenting product, okay? You understand this? No matter how you're presenting product, if you start adding these type of questions every time, and please realize they don't have to be this like big reveal of product. They just have to be comments, okay? Let me give you an example. Let's say, for example, how many of you are PC? How many foodies, Pamper Chef people do I have? Okay. Let's say you use one of your great stones to make a dish, and in this dish, there's shrimp in it. Okay. I know technically what you're wanting to know is, hey, who's interested in buying stones? Okay, I understand that. But if you ask instead on a scale of 1 to 10, how much does your family enjoy shrimp in their meals, you're going to get a lot more comments. And then you can follow that up in a private message with, hey, what else does your family like to eat? How many are in your family? How many nights a week are you cooking? What's your biggest challenge that you're facing? Okay. The whole idea is just to get them to engage in the party. Okay. So you're going to have to, like, this is kind of hard to remember and put your head around at first, but it really pays off if you'll practice this. Just ask questions that will get people to talk. Okay, can you feel that, guys? Ask questions that will get them to talk. Ask them what their favorite color is to wear instead of how badly do you need a new lipstick? Okay, like, they're not gonna answer that, but they will answer what do they prefer, coral, pinks, mauves, you know, reds, what color do they prefer to wear? Versus, you know, what's the last tube color you ran out of you'd love to order from me? Like, you can't, I know that's what you want to know, but we have a whole system to take that one answer about shrimp, that one answer about favorite color pink or red to wear, that one answer about that one thing. We have a way for you to continue to show how much you care by digging deeper and asking a few questions, okay? I promise you this works. It's really amazing. And so we have this thing we call the question tree. And we split your product. Now, this is like an advanced version of what I'm telling you. I like to take your products and divide them into sections, okay? Like, if you're anything house, so my girl down here, Julie, she's my clever container gal, she's awesome. She is organizing houses. Some of you are decorating houses, some of you are cleaning houses, some of you, you know, 31 gifts. There's lots of company that has stuff to do with houses. You can just divide your party up into rooms of the house, okay? She's for sure gonna do office. She has the cutest office anyone you've ever seen, okay? She's gonna for sure do office because that's one of her fortes. You're gonna do kitchen, you're gonna do toy room, you're gonna do some stuff like that, okay? And each one of these, what I call, so that's a category, we call it a branch. And each one of those, then I'm gonna divide it into parts. So think about in an office, okay? You're gonna have things that go on your shelves. You're gonna have paperwork. You're gonna have your, you know, like your pens and your tools. You're gonna have, you know, you're gonna have these different things that hang on the wall. You're gonna have different categories like that, okay? What types of these paperwork are you fighting with in your office? You know, medical bills and statements, household bills, stuff for taxes, you know, you're gonna have these like different categories, and we call all these twigs. If your makeup, let me give you a really simple example. Our category would be eyes, that would be our branch. In our twigs, we're gonna have eyeliner, eyeshadow, eyebrows, mascara. And we demo those, and every time we do a demo or post an image, a video, Facebook Live, we ask a question. So when we talk about eyeliner and we're showing eyeliner, we go, okay, I wanna know from you guys, do you like eyeliner on your top lid, bottom lid, or both? So you demo it and you ask a question every single time. Okay, are y'all like seeing the vision in this? Like, who's having some like aha moments? Okay. Oh no, it is not hard to do with hair accessories. My mom's a beautician. I can come up with a million questions for you on hair accessories. Okay. There's always a reason to do something different with your hair. You see me, you guys see my pictures. If you see my videos, you know, like, I never like, oh my heck, I cannot stand having my hair the same way. I love questions about hair. Sarah, girl, we got you covered, okay? Seriously. I can't go off on every company. If I start now, we'll be here all day, okay? Hair is super fun. All right, so the whole idea behind, okay, so then the other thing we do after people comment is I want you to have a little conversation right there in your party. And after you, as you have moved into that conversation, let me tell you one of the really cool things you can do. Okay, I have a thing I call adding value. Now, I bet each one of you could have like 10 categories in your company. You could have 10 different types of recipes, 10 different rooms or areas to decorate, to organize, or clean. You could have 10 different things about makeup and skin, 10 different things. And each one of those, you could probably list 10 tips. What you want to have is like either a tutorial, like a little video you have recorded, or a PDF, 10 tips to organize your office, 10 tips to help your, 3 to 5 year old learn their ABCs, 10 tips. And we have all these little like how to's. I know they're all in your head. If they're not in your head, I know you know where to find the information. Okay. You love what you do. A lot of you are with the company you're with because you love to cook, you love to organize, you love children, you're passionate about literature, whatever it is. Most of you are with your companies because you're passionate about what the product does, right? Okay. You have this knowledge in your head and you're taking for granted that everybody else knows it. And I'm telling you, they don't. Okay. I take for granted that y'all should know how to ask questions and you don't. That's my job security. Okay. That's all right. You have job security because not everybody knows what you know. So as I'm having this conversation with this person that said they love shrimp, they love to have fish in their family. Okay. And this might be a little too narrow and more too specific, but I might have 10 great recipes for different types of fish. Let's say you have a family who's trying not to eat red meat or whatever. Would you like my 10 favorite recipes on fish? Yes. Okay, great. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna add you as a friend because you won't see the message from me if we're not friends. Then I'm gonna send that to you. Did you see how I did that? Okay. Do you add the friends of everybody in the party? No. Don't ask me that. No, of course not. That's tacky. That's rude. That's not going to win friends and influence people. We add friends of those we're having conversations with in the party. Are you with me? So hopefully it's 5 to 10 people every time you have a party. Okay. 5 to maybe even 20. All right. So we want to start a conversation. Tell them we have some information we want to share with them. Tell them we want to add them as a friend. Then we do our branches there. We ask them about all the different ages of their kids. We ask them about all the different rooms of their house. We ask them more about their cooking and their needs. We talk to them about what they need, and we go through the branches with them personally. So this is what's so cool. I had someone mention to me this morning in our coaching call. She said, I had this hostess, and she was really worried that her friends would feel like the books were expensive. She was with Usborne. She asked me to only show books that are between $5 and $10. Now, Usborne books are awesome. They have lots of books between $5 and $10, but they also have books that are $30 and $40 because they're more like textbooks, okay? I said, it's no big deal. What's so cool about that is as long as they comment on one of the books, you move it to a private message, you're going to get to find out the person who needs a textbook. Then you can make that suggestion and you don't have to post it in the party and make the hostess uncomfortable. It's all about making it personal. Okay. Can you see that? It's really amazing. We've even had, sorry that the other example is about Usborne again, but technically one of the cool things we're doing with Usborne is they post a question. It might be, it's usually at least about 24 hours before the party starts. Tell us the name of the ages of your children and their interests. And then they just do a Facebook Live and they have a whole stack of books right next to them. And they have examples for every person who commented. And so they go, Susie, you said you had a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old. And she shows these different books and she asks about, how many of you have 3 and 5-year-olds and how many of the ABCs do they know? And then people are commenting in the live and they're holding up books and they're talking about books. You don't have to plan anything. You could do a whole Facebook Live. You could ask something about which of these meals would you love to have some new ideas on? Breakfast, lunch, and snacks, or dinner? And let's say you have way more people say lunch and snacks. Go ahead, do a live on snacks and on lunches, and that could be your party. You don't have to schedule anything out. You could just do Facebook Lives from here on out with the way that things are now. And it's saved there. Then the people who couldn't come that night, it's there for them to watch after the fact. And if somebody has a comment after, hey, I need, you know, some ideas for this, hey, that was in the Facebook Live. It's about 10 minutes in. You're going to love it. Okay. This is amazing. Between the technology that we have and the way that we can help you add questions and get people to talk to you so you know what they need, and then you move it to the private message, the sky is the limit with the amount of people you can reach, how far out, how, you know, depending on if your country, your company goes international or they're just local, okay? The amount of sales you can do is unlimited. I have one gal, she goes live, she has 6 parties going at the same time. She pushes those lives from her page into all 6 parties. She goes and shares it in those 6 areas. She has 6 parties going on at a time. Okay, she did like $1,500 in sales last week because, well, she might have, it might have been, was it 4 or 5 parties? One was a complete dud. That'll happen. One was kind of lame-o, but still had some sales, and 3 rocked. Would that work for you guys? Would you like be disappointed if that happened? Okay. And here you didn't have to pack everything up and take it anywhere. You're just sitting there in front of your camera, okay? You can use BeLive TV, you can use Facebook Live directly. Zoom, if you get the right type of Zoom, it'll go live. Okay, there's so many options. But it doesn't matter what option you use. If you're not using questions and going to a private message and getting to know them, you're never going to have the sales you want. Okay, this is a complete game changer, guys. I'm telling you, you can totally do this because I know... If you were at a booth or expo, I know if you were in somebody's home and you got talking to them, they had 6 kids and they're trying to eat healthier. I know you would have a conversation with them and you'd have some great ideas for them, right? Okay. Or whatever your product is, whatever their need is, whatever their concern is, you've got to start visualizing it like you're sitting there on the couch with them at the home party. Okay. Does that make sense? Yeah, Mandy, there is a Zoom that can go live. This one is supposed to go live. It's a long story. This morning, you know. Yeah, anyway, we won't talk about that. We're just going to move forward. Okay, so I want to know your aha moments. And then we're going to tell you a little bit about our big Facebook weekend. And I want to show you where our Facebook group is and our pages. But I want to hear that aha moment. What did you hear today that you can go like, oh my gosh, that would change my party? So I want to hear from 5 of you. Just open up your microphone and tell us because we're recording. What was your aha? Take it to a PM. Who has an aha? Come on, be brave. Turn on that microphone.
Adding value.
Ooh, who's that? Who is this?
Carol Jacobs.
Hi, Carol. What do you sell?
Well, I just really appreciated you saying ask questions. You know, I was thinking about my VP part, my virtual parties that I have. I don't really ask too many questions. And it brought me back to a party I had this week. And the lady, she actually followed my directions when I said, have your website open during the live party that I have. And she was able to answer the questions. So they actually do listen and do what you tell them to do. And I was thinking, oh my gosh, I really never thought about that they actually do it.
Yeah.
So that's my aha. I need to incorporate more questions with practically every post.
Nice.
Video, I don't have my video on because it has me upside down, so I just I take it off.
I love thinking you're hanging from this some type of yoga you're doing at the same time as training. You're so funny. Awesome. I'm so glad that was helpful. Thanks for sharing that, Carol.
Yeah, you bet.
This is Marcy, and adding value, the 10 tips really got to me. That was my aha moment.
Awesome.
Yeah. Now I just have to break down. We've got so many products.
Which company are you?
31.
Oh, so and try not to think about it in products, but categories of education.
Okay, because we've got organized to purses, to accessories, to jewelry, mm-hmm. to totes, to thermals. So I would break each one of those down then.
Yeah, but try to think about it like trying to keep food hot or cold would be one thing.
Okay.
together right. would be organizing a playroom. Another one would be, you know, think about how you break down your party, 10 tips on that. So it's right. okay to put in the tips that, hey, by the way, this is a great tip and here's a great product that will help you with that. Mm-hmm. But you've got to get it. It takes some practice, but if you can right. move towards education sections instead of product sections, it will go a long ways.
Okay. All right. Great. So education. I'm going to write that down.
Yep.
Thank you so very much.
You're so welcome. Glad to have you. All right. Who else?
Hi, it's Mandy with It Works Global. And
say your company one more time.
It Works Global.
Oh, It Works. Yes. Go ahead. Sorry.
Oh, it's okay. My aha moment was when you said to post like a picture of my family mm-hmm. and get to talk about their family and themselves and the heart. I never thought about that.
Nice. Yeah, that was I have seen It Works parties because most don't teach to add questions, like completely a total game changer by adding questions to all the products that they demo. So It Works has a lot of success with this type of parties. So it's cool.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Mandy. All right, awesome. Who's next?
My aha moment was the branching tree. I think that's brilliant. I don't know how to do that with Usborne.
Sweetie, I can tell you. You just do it by ages.
Well, that's what I was going to say. Typically, we do ages, but I didn't know if there was a more creative way to do that. Like, I mean,
you can also
them sometimes.
Okay, so do you happen to be a homeschool mom or do you work with homeschool parents?
No, I don't.
Okay, so just for kicks and giggles, let me tell you one other way. You can also do it by subject. Now, I know sometimes there's some subjects that wouldn't be for babies and stuff, but as a homeschool mom, one of the things that an option that we're taught is to have everybody in your house doing the same period of history. So you start them out little, and you have four different eras of history. And by the time they're seniors in high school, you've gone through all four of them three times. And you don't have to necessarily do what the school system's doing, okay? So let's say you set, you know, you showed all things World War II, and you showed, like, the sticker book that's for really young, and you showed one that a middle schooler could read, and it's, you know, more of, like, a novel, and then you showed, like, more of the textbook one. You can also do it in subjects and show, like, the same type of thing but for different types of age groups.
Okay.
Did you kind of feel that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. So that's another way to do it. Or you could even do it kind of by learning styles. But that really depends on how educated you are on that type of subject. Like, don't do it if you're not comfortable with it.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. What other, two more aha moments.
This is Debbie.
Hi, Debbie.
Hi. This is my first time joining you, Michelle. I'm really liking it. My aha moment was I ask a lot of questions, but they're around the products that I'm showing them. I'm a close to my heart rep, and it's more about crafting and that kind of thing, or colors or stuff like that. My aha moment was when you said, think about talking to them as if you were in the room with them and you were having a conversation in somebody's living room, because you would ask them, oh, you know, how long have you lived here, or how many kids do you have, or, you know, what do you like to do with your free time? Are you working or retired? You know, you have those kind of personal moments with people, and that's the part I guess I'm not doing, because my parties are successful, but I want to up the game, so I'm going to try to add some of these questions in, more personal.
So guess what, Debbie? Close to my heart was my first gig, and adding questions about what they want to scrapbook, what they want to craft, you can double your sales in like 30 days.
Yeah.
So these questions are complete game changers, because I'd already had a title and earned a trip, and I like doubled that in a really short amount of time, all because of the way I added questions about what they actually wanted to create, not about what they wanted to actually the outcome to be.
Thanks.
It's pretty cool. Yeah, it's really awesome. All right, one more. Thank you, Debbie.
You're welcome.
I love your cute little backdrop, all your little stuff back there. That's super cute. All right, who's next?
I was wondering if, for me, my aha moment was...
Tell us your name and what company you're for. Just...
I'm Clotilde, and it's H2O at Home.
Okay, cool.
And I'm pretty new to it all, but for me, my aha moment was this is actually a viable way to do a party. It never occurred to me that you could do an entire party from your home. And so I have one quick question from the question queen. Are you doing this in a Facebook invite, or are you doing it in a group that you set up specifically for the party? How are people actually doing these on Facebook?
Yeah, you can do it either via an event or via a group. A lot of what I teach coincides better with a group than it does with an event. But it's not like what I teach wouldn't work for an event. It's just the way I do hostess coaching and add people to the group and stuff. It works better in a group. But yeah, you just use one of those. And yeah, there's a lot more to it than that that I can't like totally go into right now. But yeah, you just do it online on your Facebook account. And you just add a new group every time you have a party or you add a new event.
Great. Thank you.
Okay. You bet. Alrighty, so we have this really awesome, so I'm going to show you where the Facebook group is and our Facebook page. So we will fix this tonight, okay? We will have one more of these tonight. It's 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific, and it will go live on Facebook. This one should have gone live. It's, do you have those days where things just go wrong and you're just like, anyway, gotta just like pick yourself up, keep going. So it should have gone live this morning and it didn't, but it will tonight. So you have another opportunity to take part in this and your team does, okay? But we have this whole, and so I'm gonna show you where that is. We have this whole weekend, this coming weekend, it's Friday night for 4 hours and 8 hours on Saturday. We do take an hour lunch, but it's so, so exciting. What we do is we teach you a ton about hostess coaching with regards to questions. We have these really cool ways where we have our hostess go post three of our most popular questions on her wall so that then she finds out who's wearing makeup, who has kids, who has whatnot. And it's a really, really, really cool way to figure out who to have them invite to the party. It's so smart. You're going to love it. You're just going to be floored, okay? And then we have these other questions we call them, who do you know? We put people into categories. And so we help your hostess pre-qualify the right people to invite, not just her best, you know, 50 best girlfriends or 50 people she can, you know, connects with most on Facebook. So we have a whole big section on hostess coaching. And on also, we do some stuff also on booking parties. I have some really specific wording. The way I message people, I have a very good understanding of the fact that you can't see people's body language. All you can see is words. There's a lot of things you've got to do different to book parties when you can't see people's faces and those paranoid monkeys can pop up so quickly. So we have some really amazing wording that books a lot more parties, okay? Then we're going to help you create your party. We're going to help you figure out your branches. We're going to help you figure out the twigs. We're going to help you create questions for them. We want you to get as much put together as possible. So I'm a SynthShare fan. So whether you're using SynthShare or you're using Post My Party, whatever you like to use, that you can take what you learned this weekend, start creating it, post it in there, so then you can just rebatch it and use it over and over again. We want you to get as much as your party created this weekend as possible. Now you may have a video to record, or you may need to plan out your Facebook Live with where you're gonna add questions in it. So you may have some stuff that you can't completely do while we're, you know, live on a Zoom like this, but we want you to get as much done as possible. And I cannot tell you, like, every person who does it like this, they're like, oh my gosh, I'm getting the same amount of sales as I did at home parties. Oh my gosh, the engagement has gone off the charts. I never had anything like this. Oh my gosh, I'm booking so many more parties. I'm getting to know people. You're going to find recruits, okay? because you're actually getting to know people and you're not just pushing information out, it will be a complete and utter game changer. Okay. This is really, really exciting. And I'm telling you, I've done the home parties. I know exactly how to do those and how to ask the questions. We've translated this into the virtual parties and it is exciting and you feel good. Okay. Isn't there anything more awful than I really want to have success and I want to sell, but boy, I don't want to feel crappy about myself doing it. Okay. We make sure you feel really authentic. That is our whole goal, is you feel good and the client feels good and they get the product out of the box and they use it as soon as they get it because they got what they were excited about. There wasn't any impulse buying. Okay. So that weekend is $97. So think about it. One good party and it's paid for. That's it. One good party and it's paid for. Shannon, she's going to put the links here, but you also got an email with the links for this. When you sign up for the weekend, we're going to give you, we have a whole membership where we have videos on every subject, mindset, recruiting, sales, finding new customers, booths and expos. We have all these videos and we have this thing called the question tree where you have access to 2,000 questions you can use for your social media needs, for your parties, for your Facebook groups. So that is $29.97 a month and you get 1 month for free when you sign up for that. Now, we have this other thing. Some of you said you're new. Some of you have been following me a while and you know you love what we do, but you're like, how many of you love what I do, but you're still like, I want to implement it better? Who knows what I do, but like, dang it, I really want to get good at this. So we've added a brand new class. We're calling it Social Media 101, okay? And what we're going to do with this is we're going to have a 30-day Facebook group. Okay, let me step back for 2 seconds. Both the weekend and the thing I'm going to talk about right now, every minute of them is recorded and you get the recordings, okay? So you can watch it as many times as you like. If you can't be there for the whole weekend, you can't be there for any of it, you'll get the recordings and you get 30 days in a Facebook group to help support you and implement what you learn, okay? Our social media 101 class, we're going to do that over several, I think it's 4 weeks. We're going to give you assignments on how to get your social media going, just on your profile, how to do it right, what to say, what not to say, what to ask, what to be posting about, and how to be finding new clients from your current friends list, okay? Our next goal is how to message correctly, okay? Oh my gosh, the cold messaging that is being taught is we can't keep doing it the way we're doing it in this industry, okay? I cannot tell you how passionate I am about this. I love growing teams. I love helping other people have this opportunity to work from home, to be a stay-at-home mom, to supplement their income, to pay off that medical bill, to get that new reliable car, to go on that dream vacation, okay? I want you to have those things that you need, and recruiting is one of the best ways to do that. As we're self-vomiting and spamming all over Facebook and sending these obnoxious cold messages, how many people are gonna wanna be in our industry if we keep doing it so badly, right? Are y'all with me? Do you know what I'm saying? Okay. I'm just like, oh, come on, guys. This initial touch, this asking questions, knowing how to take a no, we're going to teach you all about really effective messaging. I know it's scary, but gosh, when you do it right, it feels good. There's a way better way to do it. Okay. And I know leaders are going to start teaching it as soon as they learn it. But there's a lot of people who don't know any better. They mean well. They're trying to help you be successful. But y'all know you don't send those messages. You hate them or you send them and you feel crappy and you don't get anywhere with them anyway. We have a much better way for you, okay? So we're going to teach you more about that. We're then going to hit on a little bit on Facebook groups and your parties. But it's going to be social media 101 and how these questions are complete game changers, okay? So that is a $47 value. When you buy the Facebook Party Weekend and the Social Media 101 together, it's $147, but we give you 3 months of our membership for free, which is a $90 value, Okay. We want you to have that membership because all those little pieces really support what you learn. You want to be able to go back and watch those, watch the mindset, watch the goal setting, and watch all those things. It's really, really awesome. Okay. So we have these great, great trainings for you. We can't teach you everything in 1 hour, and we can't give you really good examples for every one of your companies. When you come to these events, I slow down and take time to make sure each of you have questions, have categories, have ideas for your company specifically. Julie, I should have messaged you on the spot. Would you mind telling them about your experience in some of the weekends you've been on with me? Are you comfortable with that, my clever container, Julie?
It's been awesome. I really like that there is an in-depth training option like this, that we can, you know, really not just touch on the surface of something, but go deeper into it, and that she's there to answer specifics to our particular companies, and we brainstorm with each other, and it's awesome. I will be doing this weekend for other training.
So tell them about how we connect with the other gentlemen and gals in the weekend. It's fun. Everybody kind of gets to know each other, huh?
Yeah. And then you wind up getting friend requests from other people that are in the event. And you like their pages and brainstorm.
Yep. So Debbie, can you message us, message me personally on Facebook? I'm not 100% sure what you're asking for, but I will help you. I'll get whatever that is. It's just hard to do right now when I'm talking to a whole group of people, but we'll hook you up. So just message me privately, okay? The hours. Thank you. Okay. So on Friday, they start at 3 p.m. Pacific, which is 6 p.m. Eastern. Go for 4 hours. Then on Saturday, they start at 7 a.m. Pacific, 10 a.m. Eastern, and they go for 8 hours. Okay. So we would love to have you join us on these camps. We know that this is the answer to doing business in a totally different way, to maximizing your hours. We want you to make a lot more per hour. We want people to be loyal customers. There's so many good things that we have for you. Okay. And we're really, really excited for you to have those things. Let me show you really quick. Let me do a quick screen share on where our Facebook group is and where our Facebook page is. I just gotta get it right. Okie dokie. So this is our Facebook group. And Shannon, maybe you can grab the Facebook page link for them. Okay, so be sure and join this group because we do Facebook Lives. There are lists of free questions in here we post all the time. There's a lot of engagement, a lot of connection that we make in here. So be sure and jump into this group and join the group because it's a lot of fun, okay? And I just put the links over in the comments. Shannon will grab the link. This is our Facebook page. And what's really cool is if you go to, so the Facebook page is here. And if you go over here to events, you'll see a little button that says subscribe. So you want to like the page, and then it would be right here, but because I've subscribed to it, it doesn't show up. There's a little button that says subscribe, and we have lots of stuff coming up. Next week, we're going to be talking about how to train your team, coach your team, train your new ones, train your current ones, get them motivated with some really cool stuff that's I don't ever see anybody else teach all on coaching. Then we're going to be talking about how to use Facebook in your groups. And then for those of you that have auto ships, we're going to have a whole event on finding and maintaining auto ship clients. And I think you're gonna be really excited how we use Facebook groups and how authentic it is. So it's really, really, really fun. All right. So be sure and grab those and like the page and subscribe so you see those that are coming up. All righty. So I'm gonna just answer any of your questions. We'll do about 10 more minutes. I'm so sorry about the technical problems we had this morning. Thank you for being so understanding. So if you have any questions, be sure and ask us. Know that a ton of this is going to go on in the Facebook weekend. Some of you are saying, you know, we'll have money by the first or some of those things. Be sure and message us on Facebook. We'll see what we can do to help you work with you. We want you there. We know it'll make you more money. We're human. We're not computers. We can sometimes do some little tweaking to help you pay for it in a more easy way, but we want you there. We know what this means to you and your families. We know that there's people who are waiting to meet you and need you, and all by the way that you interact with them will show that more by using these skills, okay? We want your true hearts to be shown. That's our goal. All right, so I'm going to open up for questions. If you'll please open your microphone and ask me instead of type it in the notes. I don't read I can't read and talk at the same time. And then Shannon usually also, if for some reason you don't have a microphone, she usually will read them and help me know who I need to answer questions for. So any questions y'all have about Facebook parties or any of the programs we have coming up?
A question.
Michelle.
Woo!
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
All right, go ahead. Beverly, you go ahead and then.
Yeah, I just had a question about the initial touch when you don't remember something personal about them and they aren't a previous customer, what kind of opening sentence would you use? We have like papers that people fill out at our events, whether they want to book a show or more interested in whatever. So right. I don't always get to talk to everybody.
Okay. So one of the things, if it's at a booth or expo, you're going to have to give a little more information. I'm trying to remember, Beverly, do you have access? Are you a member of our 2997 program?
No, I know at the expo how to do it, but
no,
if
I know.
Customer care.
No, I know.
And then how to do it on the internet.
Right. No, I understand that. I'm trying to get an idea of what your foundation is before I start talking.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Have you watched the videos on booths and expos?
No.
No. Okay. Okay. So you definitely want to watch those so you set up your booths and expos and your drawing slip just a little bit differently, because then when you message them, you're going to have something to talk to them about. Okay. So just as a FYI, be sure and watch those. So the idea is, so you're saying this person said they wanted to have a party and you did not talk to them at all.
Well, either that or I don't remember anything that they said that I would start a conversation with.
Okay, so one of the things you want to do, so I put the drawing slip box like far back and I put them on clipboards and I have them hand me the clipboards. And so if we talk, I write as many notes as I can really fast. Little girl with pink dress, had a little sister and she just kept spinning. And, you know, like I do everything I can to find something I can message them about, okay? If you know you talked to them, but you can't remember exactly what you talked to them, I like to leave out the name of the company and say, hey, Susie, we met at this booth and expo. We had so much fun talking about cooking. Do you have a quick minute that we can chat a little bit more?
Okay.
So you work really hard to leave out any sort of mention of product or the company name, but you say we talked about cooking or we talked about makeup or we talked about your kids and getting them to learn to love to read. Okay. So you try to refer back to that.
Yeah, because I was right on the slips where I got them. Because I can do that when I get home. You know, I got them at the craft show, or I got them at the expo, or...
Right. But the way we ask questions on the drawing slips will give you some things to ask them about. So you got to watch those videos, because it's too much for me to explain right now.
Okay.
Really, it's a game changer. So my gal Amy down here, I don't know if you see Amy, maybe you guys can message. I know she's watched them, and she's Pampered Chef. And she'll tell you, like, you got to get those videos. Like, they are a complete game changer. I've had Pampered Chef people do one booth and, like, book out 6 months because the way our drawing slips are set up. So it's good content, really good content. All right?
All right, thanks.
You bet. All right, who is next? Go ahead, hun.
So I'm interested in the weekend workshop, but I kind of got a busy weekend where I'm going to be in and out. So yeah, this is something that I can, okay.
Yep, you can watch the parts where you're, and I'm not sure if she's on here, but one of my clients, seriously, she has her, we went with her to her kids' band event, we were in the car with her driving everywhere, she gets every minute humanly possible, and then she asks questions when she can, and then she watches the recordings, and I'm serious. It's the people that are like no excuse people completely crack me up, because they just, I just go along with them all day long. And
for some reason, it never occurred to me that I could just take my phone, because right now I'm on my laptop. So, yeah. Okay. Yeah. That makes more sense.
You know, unless it's a place where, you know, like if it's a baby shower and they're talking, you know, it's like not politically correct, but, seriously, we went to the baseball game with her. Like, her, it's so funny because the backdrop behind her kept changing, you know, because she kept going to all these things with her kids all day long. We were with her. So if it's those places where it's like, oh, I got to cheer my kid on while they're out batting, but I can listen to it most of the time. You know, it depends on the activity, but people do. Or if they're traveling, we travel with them. And everybody changed. People are nursing. We've had naked husbands walk behind. We've seen it all. I'm not kidding. Like, they're, you know, I don't know. I'm like, how do our webinars end up with nudity in them? But no, not really. But it's pretty funny. So really, like, we know you're trying to work your business around your life. Take us with you. We are happy to go with you. It's fun. You'll have the video. You'll want to watch the recordings, even if you caught every minute of it, because you won't remember all of it. It's a lot of content. It's so fun. Oh my gosh, we have so much fun. We work really hard.
Cool. Thank you.
You bet. All right. Who else has a question?
So I don't want to sound like a dunce, but
you sound like a dunce.
This boot camp tomorrow. On Saturday this weekend, we're actually having our U-Bam day on Saturday, so there's going to be 11 of us at my house.
Oh.
Are they set? Because when I looked at, when I clicked the link, it said 3 60-minute sessions. Is that something different, or am I just reading it wrong?
Which class are you looking at? You must be looking at the social media 101 isn't a weekend. It's a, we're going to do it over a couple of weeks because we knew you need follow up on it.
Okay. Then I clicked the wrong one.
The weekend camp. So, Lauren, is it this Lauren, right? With Usborne?
Yes. Yep. Okay.
So are you in Nancy Ann's group?
No. Mm-mm.
But you have a big Usborne. Okay. So you're going to laugh. This is how crazy I am. During the 1 hour that we take for lunch, I'm doing a thing just for Usborne for that hour. Because I know y'all have training all that weekend.
Yeah.
Usborne one by me. It's at, I think it's 1 p.m. Eastern. Anyway, so yeah, it's, but even if you can be on Friday night and a couple of hours on Saturday, you'll get the recording. You'll love it. It'll be totally worth it. And the other cool thing, if you're Usborne, there's a group of ladies that all connect together. They have a Facebook group, and you're only allowed to be in the group if you've taken a weekend camp for me. And so they all share ideas. They all share their Facebook group stuff. They all share how they're doing their parties, and they're applying it to my content. And the only way you can get in that group is if you're on a camp. And they're okay. Amazing ladies ever. Like, it's worth it just to get in that group. Because they are working so hard and so smart. Like, I just love them. And I mean, one gal, like, yeah, my goal for the month is 3,000 in sales, and I've hit 4,000, and she has a week left to go. Like,
oh, geez.
Dang, girl. you know? And so they're going really well. It's really cool.
So the training that you're doing at that lunch hour, is that just specific to their group, or can other Uzzies join?
Oh no, it's for all of Usborne, because I guess Usborne's having like get your training on day. I don't know.
Yeah, it's you, Bam Day. It's in lieu of regionals this year.
Yeah, and so one of the really, really, really big leaders. If you message me on Facebook, I'll get you the link so you can share it with your team. So.
Oh, perfect. Thank you.
Who knows Nancy Ann? What's Nancy Ann's last name? Warman or something like that. So she's earned 21 trips. She's been with, I don't know, like she's got 5,000 on her team or something like that. So she's sharing it with her team, but all of Usborne can join us that hour. It's called Social Media 101 for Usborne Books.
Okay.
So it'll be good.
I would love that. Thank you.
You're welcome. But yeah, join the weekend camp and it'll be awesome. But you can't, like, each person would have to have their own membership
in
their house. Do you know what I mean? You can't pay for one Channel 11 watch. That's not fair to those who pay.
No, I completely understand.
Yeah. Okay?
Thanks.
Awesome, you bet. All righty, who else had a question? No, Andrew, you don't have access to the camp videos if you sign up for the crate independently. You have to do the camp to have access to those.
Hello.
Hi.
Yes, I had a question where do you get to the point to be able to send a friend request to your guest? Just a like from a question and then say, hey, I'll follow up in a private message, or?
I usually, you can kind of feel when they start to get comfortable with you. You know, they say the meal we have most as a family is dinner, and you go, cool, what are your family's favorite things to eat? You know, how often are you eating at home or eating out? You know, you kind of have a little conversation and you try to reveal some more needs. You have a reason. Message them. So there's not like this one answer, have three replies, you know, like it's probably going to be between like 2 to 5, and you know, it depends on if she's giving you one word answers or she's giving you a short paragraph.
Okay. So you don't just automatically add in, you know, friend request to everybody. You just, those that you need a personal relationship. Well, you know, as personal as you can get on a Facebook relationship with. Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, because you don't want their friends to tell the hostess, I can't believe she friended all of us.
Yeah, I was trying to figure out. Okay.
Yep. Yeah, you want to have a reason, you know, have a little bit of connection, she's answered something, and it's that you have something you want to give her, so you know, have a real reason for friending them, so we don't
look. Yes. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi, I have a question. Carol Jagus, I didn't tell you earlier, but I'm with JewelScent.
Cool. What's it called again?
JewelScent.
Oh, what's that company?
It's candles and body works that have hidden jewels in the side.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Like fragrant jewels. Okay. I hate to mention it, but you see those all the time.
Okay.
But we just have the hidden jewelry inside the candles or creams or whatever.
Okay.
So on your, I had a question. I was thinking about your question, lady. On your scale of 1 to 10s, or any questions that you want to ask, do you just do the question, or do you like put the question in a graphic and post it?
Okay, so we're only talking Facebook parties right now. There's other rules for Facebook groups and Facebook on your profile. When you're talking parties, you don't need to do it separate in a, like in a, either just text or in an image. You're supposed to post it with the demo. You know what I mean? Whether it's a picture of, you know, let's say you had 5 different scents. Look at all these fun new scents we have for this season. How many days a week do you typically burn a candle in your home?
Oh, okay. So you do. Basically, you are answering my question.
Yeah, you're combining it with what you're already doing now. It's not a separate post.
Okay. All right. So you ask the question inside of the post that you're posting a picture of, basically. Yeah. Okay, well, very good.
You just type text. You know, you post the picture and then you type text above it.
Right.
Yeah.
Perfect.
But just know that there's a little bit different rules for Facebook groups and on your profile.
So just, yeah, I do event pages. I don't do groups on my part.
No. I mean a VIP customer group.
Uh-huh.
We're really, 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 really big into how you get repeat sales through a VIP customer group.
Oh, right. Uh-huh.
And that's a whole different like lesson and structure and way we do it. It's similar, but not exactly the same. So I just don't want you to think that rule is for everything because it's not.
Okay. No, I was just more or less talking about on your, I call it a VP party, not the VIPs. It's just an online Facebook party that you're hosting.
Yep.
Okay.
Questions, everything you already were posting before.
Very good. Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. Well,
hi, Michelle. It's Hi. Lisa, Damsel in Defense.
Hi, Helen. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. Okay, so along with her talking about, are you guys talking about the VIP group? Uh-huh. So what is the difference? Because I have my business page. I have my personal page. I don't have a VIP group set up yet. I'm fairly new. Life has kind of taken over, and I'm trying to get back in and really work your trainings.
Cool.
So tell me about the difference between the business page, the VIP group. Do you ever post on personal page?
You're asking a really big loaded question, but that's
okay. Where can I find the answer?
This is an FYI. We do have a Facebook group. Okay. So the short answer is you want to have a Facebook group because Facebook shows those notifications to the people in the group far better than people that have liked your page.
Okay. Now,
there is a time and a reason for a Facebook page. And if you get something like SynthShare where you can post on your page and in your group at the same time, you don't have to work twice as hard. You just can post it in both places. Okay.
Okay.
I call a Facebook page like your profile, a portfolio. Like if they put in your name, you know, Lisa Damsel in Defense, your Facebook page will come up, but your group won't come up in a Google search. Okay.
Okay.
So you want the page there just as it's like the foyer room in your house. Like we don't need foyers. Nobody sits there and talks. It's not a room that's needed. It's just what you got to have, you know, it's just like, it's what we do. Right. Okay. So it's pretty. It's not necessarily for drumming up sales, but it's a place for you to put your videos and some other stuff like that. Your okay. group is your, okay, so this is what I call Facebook. I call your parties, I don't care, or booth, or any place you meet people for the first time or you're getting to know them. I call that a first date or a blind date.
Mm-hmm.
Your Facebook group is that place where you build your relationship. Because, you know, they might buy one safety, you know, something that keeps them safer,
right.
But they need the internet, they need the traveling, you know, they won't buy everything they need. So you want a Facebook group where they can continue to know you, and you do 5-day series on different topics, so they'll continue to buy other products that keep them safe in other areas of their life that they didn't cover the night that they met you.
Okay.
So we have a weekend camp on that. It's phenomenal. We love our weekend camp on the 5-day series. You can buy the last camp and just watch the videos on your own and join the Facebook group.
Mm-hmm. We'll
have one coming up. So whether you want to do it live or listen to it recorded, you can get that content today if you want it.
Okay.
It depends on if you want to participate in a live weekend or not.
Sure.
So, it's the Facebook groups are seriously the key to getting phenomenal repeat sales on a consistent basis and staying in front of your people. Like, we are crazy excited about them. Anyone here, you can put over in the chat if you've been on a Facebook weekend group. People are getting enough sales weekly to constitute a party. Like, it's really phenomenal. It's exciting.
So is the group kind of where you combine personal plus business? It's kind of the combination of the two?
Yeah, I would put some personal in there, but it's about education.
Sure. Okay. Right.
You know, when somebody goes, oh my gosh, how do I keep my kids safe of this? Or, oh my gosh, my daughter's going to college. Crap. What have I not told her? You know, like, and they go, okay, I would know the answer. Like, you want to be that person people think about when they want to keep someone safe, when they have something happen to their internet, when they've, you know what I mean? It's like,
yes,
they don't think about it until something bad happens first. Oh my gosh, how am I going to fix this? How am I going to keep this from happening again? I want them to think about you because of all the great ideas you have. And it's okay to say this idea works well with this product. Mm-hmm. But, you know, like, so my gal Julie, that's a Clever Container, like, shares all the time tips on how to be organized. And by the way, this little tool that you want to buy and put in your kitchen cupboard is going to help that stay organized, you know? Like,
sure. Okay.
Okay. So it's really, really, really cool. But we add questions. There's like a whole system behind it, but it works. And you can be consistent about it and you'll love it. And you'll find hostesses there. You'll find new recruits there. Like, your group is like the core to your business.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Lisa. All right. Message us if you need the links to that or if you want to know when the next live one is.
Michelle, where would I ask about a problem with the recordings for the last Facebook weekend?
Problems with the recordings. So send me a private message or email Anne Marie.
Okay.
Oh, the other cool thing is the Facebook week, the weekends camps that we do, we send you the recordings, both a video and an audio only. So that way, if you want to listen to it when you're on a run or doing your, like if you're somewhere from home and you don't have internet service, you don't want to eat up your data, we also upload them as audio only. And that really helps. Some people love the audio only. So there, we really work hard to make it so that content's very accessible on that. So Grace, sweetie, this closes down and I won't see these messages. If you'll go friend me on Facebook and message me what you'd like. So Grace, hopefully you hear me. Shannon, can you grab my link to my Facebook profile and put it there? Okay. It's Michelle Hess Withers. I usually pop up pretty quick if you put all three names in there, and we'll hook you up with the links. Okay. All right. Any other questions?
Michelle.
Yeah.
How do you, when you have a company that has many different verticals, I do longevity. Okay. In the Facebook, how do you let people know that there's more than just what that one party's about? Because they may not want to do the jewelry. They're interested in the essential oils or the nutrition.
Okay, are you talking about a party or in your VIP group?
In a party. When you're talking about hosting rewards, that there's other verticals that we have available.
I should change the name of my class because I really actually believe in having classes instead of parties. So I would just like have maybe a little, an image that says, we have these really great informative classes that you're, you know, it's free information for your friends and you could, you know, we have great ideas on how to accessorize. We have great ideas on additional health options. We have great, you know, so I would, you know, make the names of the classes kind of fun and just say, here are some other types of classes that you could book. And when you have your friends come and they order product from the class, you're going to get, you know, whatever for free or half price. So I would, whatever you're most comfortable with, I wouldn't offer a class that you feel really outside your comfort zone. You'll add those as you go, you know, as you get, so you can do it in your sleep, add another one and get better at it. Just tell them these are the different types of classes you could book and share with your friends, and they're getting free information. That is very valuable to people. That's why Pinterest is so popular. That's free information. Okay. So just have different themed parties and you can just have a image that has the list there and tell them about it. Is that what you're asking? Did I answer that for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Awesome. Yeah, Youngevity. The Facebook group you definitely want to have is Youngevity because you have so many products and you have AutoShip. The Facebook group is your answer to keeping them and getting them to order new things because you have the opportunity to introduce new products to them.
Great. So, and you have a separate training on that one.
Sorry?
You have a separate training with the Facebook group?
Yep, we sure do. It's awesome. You'll love it.
Great. Thank you.
You're welcome, Brianna. All right. Anyone else?
I have one question.
Hi, Allison.
This is Allison.
Hi, what company are you with, hon?
I am with 31, and I heard the other consultant, and she asked about parties and how you would do your posts and everything. Right now, I do, like, for the home, for the kids, for the family, for the men, and all that. Is that what you're talking about when you say, like, breaking it up?
I break it up into what I call categories. The common word would be categories. We call it a branch. It's just
right.
Our logo is a tree, and I don't know. I for some reason, have this fetish of trees. So we call it the question tree, and we break into branches. Yeah. Okay. So yours, you might break into a couple different rooms of the house, and then you're going to have one that's probably more like fashion, and then maybe okay. one that's like on the go. So like okay. you add stuff about the car and about backpacks and lunch bags.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So 31 gift, the funny thing about that one's, there's more than just rooms of the house, you know what I mean? So that's what I would probably do is like,
okay.
Maybe like
inside the house, outside the house kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Allison. Yeah. It's really, there's so many fun things to do in your Facebook groups. So many questions for 31 gifts. Oh my gosh. I love working with 31 gifts. It's really fun. Really, really fun. All right, cool. Who's next? Anyone else? All right, ladies and gents. So we'll have another one of these tonight. It will go live on Facebook. So if you're on if you've liked the Facebook page, you probably get notification on that. We're going to fix all this up for tonight. Oh, goodness. We thought we had this all set, but life happens, right? So glad you all made it. And we will talk to you soon. Be sure and message us privately if you have any other questions on Facebook. Or you can also reply to the email and I or Anne Marie will take care of you. Shannon, thank you for being my guru today. I'm sure she's been answering your questions because I can't read and talk at the same time. So you guys are awesome. Remember, there's always somebody waiting to meet you. You want to know how to do these things so that you continue to build your business and got to keep your Excels in a better light for people, okay? Alrighty, guys. Thanks so much. Have a good one.